What is good? How's everyone doing? It's the morning, right? Thank you so much to Chantel for, first of all, reaching out to us and interviewing us. She's a great person, we love her. Thank you so much for inviting us to talk to you guys. Thank you, really grateful for that. So my name is Amawi Scujon, and this is my sister.
Hi everyone, thank you for having us. My name is Rosalyn.
We started a brand called Bronx Native. Who's from the Bronx here? Woo! Come on, man, PX in the house. We need a little bit more noise. you guys can tell that we love PX, right? You go to the next slide. Right, so Bronx Native is a brand that embodies what the Bronx truly is, a borough with strong, beautiful ambitions. And we attempt to expose that by highlighting and embracing our home through apparel, art, and media. Right, so we've been living in BX for our whole life, right? And we've seen the stereotypes, we've seen how underrated the Bronx is, right? And what people believe the Bronx to be. But we believe that our home, our community, our people, right? We have a beautiful community, we have beautiful people. I wish I could see you guys, but I really can't. We believe that the Bronx is this super dope, right? So we want to showcase that, and we're doing it through art, media, and apparel, right? Go to the next slide. Just like I said, art, media, and apparel, our background, we are creatives. I'm a creative and entrepreneur based in the South Bronx, my sister.
I'm a student majoring in fashion design at Parsons right now.
Yes. Parsons. You can go to the next slide. So this is us. This is a picture of us. I used to have a beard like 2 weeks ago. You can go to the next slide. Nice transition. Alright, so we... Okay, so so there's a little background on us.
So like I said before, I'm
majoring
in fashion design at Parsons, and that goes hand in hand with what we do, because the thing that we mostly create is apparel. So it's basically creating apparel for, social issues and apparel that actually means something, and it's for a cause. And we are also first generation Dominicans.
Woo! Dominicans! With our clothing, we met people from our community, people have wearing our t-shirts. You can go to the next slide. Some of our t-shirts. Right, we try to incorporate the history and the culture and our clothing, not only making clothing that is visually appealing, but that has the substance that the Bronx has. Right, it says since 1639, that was the Bronx was created. You can go to the next slide. As a couple, we got some dad hats, gotta keep up with the top culture out here. Right, so we have used a building as the iconography for our brand. You go to the next slide. That's what I'm doing. I'm doing this sweater. For all the hype beats out here. Okay. Bronx. Ever since we started this in the end of 2015 and throughout 2016, it's been a great journey, right? We've been doing events, we have partnerships with the Bronx Museum, they're selling our apparel. We've met with the mayor, Mayor de Blasio, we've met with the president of the Bronx. We've been going to schools talking to kids about entrepreneurship and about the Bronx. We've been doing interviews, we've done our own events, the journey has been amazing. What's the next slide? The journey has been so amazing. A lot of people haven't seen what we're doing, right? Because at the moment, no one is really doing this for the BS, right? So we've been on Bronx Nav, we've been on News 12. A couple articles have passed, a couple platforms have written articles about us and showcasing what we do. bring some, like last week we were on News 12, the Bronx, so this is the interview, it's like 1 minute.
Who said, like, using their skills to come together and show off their Bronx pride. News 12, the Bronx reporter, Courtney Carter Davis is from Longwood with their story.
Brother and sister duo Amaris and Rosalind Roland, who were born and raised in the Bronx, wanted to use their skills, graphic designing and fashion, to showcase the Bronx.
So we were looking online for clothing that represented the Bronx for what it really is, right? We're looking for clothing that has substance, the culture, the history, and looks visually appealing, and we could not find it. So we kind of took it upon ourselves, like, let's create a brand that embodies what the Bronx really is, right?
The shirt, like the one that I am wearing, is part of the collection that started in 2015, and through social media and a huge online presence, has exploded in popularity ever since. With the reach of the apparel, even expanding to Hollywood and the Kardashian inner circle.
Kim Kardashian's makeup artist, but overall, he's a celebrity makeup artist, like Miss Mario. He's originally from the Bronx. So yesterday, he actually posted a picture with the shirt and tagged us, and he said he was a Bronx native. So.
The siblings want to continue to focus not just on customers buying the brand-based shirts, hats, and sweatshirts, but the message.
We're using the apparel and clothing as a tool right now to have that impact. I want to tackle issues like poverty, you know, issues of health here in the Bronx that we go through every day, right? And hopefully make it a better place and tell people how out the Bronx is.
And along with Courtney Carter Jesus, News of the Bronx.
Bronx, and I want you guys to say native if possible, right? Let's do it. Bronx!